When there aren't any more, there are zero bananas. Ah, Jessica, how many oranges are in the jar?
Zero.
Yes, how many cupcakes?
Zero.
How many elephants?
Zero.
How many steamrollers?
Zero.
How many mice wearing hand-painted neckties?
Zero.
That's right. When there aren't any more of something, you have zero. You are one smart Jessica. Ah, have a banana. Wonderful.
Mm-hmm. I like to hammer nails.
I like sawing wood.
I like to paint everything bright colors.
La, 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 la. And I like to put designs on things. La, 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 la,
well, you
la,
certainly
la.
Do a good job of putting designs
oh,
on things.
Oh, thank you.
I like the way you
I
paint everything
really
bright colors there,
wood
fella.
Beautifully.
Thank you. I like
oh,
the way
I
you saw
admire
wood.
Your bright colors.
That's all right, boy.
Well, why don't we get together and make something?
Hey, great idea.
That's a great
Look,
idea.
You can pick up that bucket
I think
over
it's
there.
Wonderful.
Right, I'll get
oh,
that.
And you I'll do
that
some painting and design.
I'll take this.
So
I have,
great
I'll
to
start
cooperate.
Slide, I'll put it all together and make it.
There, it's all finished.
Well, so it
oh,
is, my goodness.
I couldn't have done it without
well,
all of you.
What an exciting-looking object.
Well,
really
thank you
pretty.
For all of the
well,
cooperation.
You're welcome. We're certainly
I
glad
think
to
this
help.
Is really great.
It's really a nice thing, and I'm glad
together.
I was able to participate in doing it.
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog. Hi all, this is Kermit the Frog outside the cottage of Red Riding Hood Grandmother's cottage. And we're expecting Little Red Riding Hood any moment now, and she'll be bringing with her her very famous basket of goodies. Now we are hoping for an exclusive inside look at that basket of goodies, and we're going to find out what's inside the basket.
Dum,
oh,
dum, dum,
hark,
dum,
I think
dum,
she's coming now.
Dum, 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 dum.
Excuse me?
Oh, Big Bad Wolf!
What?
Big Bad Wolf!
Where?
Big
what?
Bad...
Oh!
Wait. You're not Big Bad Wolf.
Of course not.
You're the Dull Green Frog.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what a relief. Wait, you sure you're not Wolf and Frog Pudding?
Positive. I'm Kermit the Frog, Sesame Street News. Now, oh. How about giving our audience an inside peek at what's inside that goodie basket? Hmm?
Yeah, for Sesame Street News?
Yes.
Sure. Okay, yeah, because... She's not feeling too good, me grandmother.
Yes,
yeah.
That's
so me
right.
Bring lots of goodies to get well by, okay? See,
mm-hmm.
Let me
mm-hmm.
show you.
This is an exciting moment, folks, as Little Red Riding Hood prepares to reveal what's inside the goodie basket.
Who are you talking to?
Never you mind. Just show us what's inside the goodie basket.
Oh, yeah, yeah. These goodies to help get grandma well.
Mm-hmm.
First goodie is strawberry twirl cookie. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Second goodie is cinnamon crisp cookie. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Then we got the banana whip cookie. Mm-hmm. And then maple walnut cookie. All make grandma real well. Yeah.
That's it? That's everything in your goodie basket?
You expecting something else, Frog?
Well, actually, yes.
Well, that's it. What?
Chicken soup.
Chicken soup?
Sure. Didn't you say your granny's not feeling well?
Yeah.
Oh, when people are sick, they want healthy things, like chicken soup and fresh vegetables and fruit. They don't want cookies.
You sure granny not want cookie? Mm-hmm. Well, we take care of that. Mm.
Well, Little Red Riding Hood, you certainly took care of the cookie problem.
Yeah.
But now you don't have any goodies to give to your granny. What
oh,
are you going to
oh,
do about that?
Oh, oh, me no. Me go to Fairyland Food Mart and get real goodies. Oranges and chicken soup and whole wheat toast
mm.
and alfalfa sprouts.
Good.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, me hope me not meet Big Bad Wolf. Oh.
She certainly seems to have a thing about wolves. But while we're waiting for Little Red Riding Hood to return, perhaps we can do a story on her grandmother. I understand she's a real sweetheart of a granny. sounds awfully sweet, too. It's Kermit the Frog of Sesame Street News. On the other hand, let's forget the granny story.
Who was that?
Oh, just some frog from Sesame Street News. Now you get back in bed, Granny. You're sick.
Okay, Dr. Wolf.
One dot, two dots, three dots. Three dots, three dots, still three dots, four dots.
Do you know what we want to do today? We want to check your eyes, okay? And are we going to have fun? I'll tell you what, you hop up here, and we're really going to have a good time. And what we want to do first is test to just see how well you can see things. And I want you to tell me which way the E goes, right? And which way does this one go? That's excellent. And which way does this fella go? Okay, let's test your vision. You're so good at that. We're just gonna cover this right over like that, and then I'm gonna have you look down towards those E's down there, and you tell me which way they go, okay? Let's put some good ones up there. Look at that. Oh, there's some goodies. Do you see those right there? Mm-mm. Which way does this one go? Very good. Now, how about this one? Okay, which way does this go? Can you see this fella right here?
Can't see it.
That's a little small. Sometimes it's hard without glasses to see all of them. Which way does this one go? Oh, that's good. You see this one okay? These get a little hard, don't they? Boy, you did a beautiful job. Let's get that frog. Let's put him to work. Can you see him up there? And have look at him down here. Watch him. Up like that. Way over like that. And way up on the ceiling. Some frogs are up there, you know. That's excellent. Okay. Look at Mommy. One more time. Right at Mommy, honey. That's good. Oh, that's excellent. But I want you to put your head up in here for me. Okay. Is it comfortable? That's good. You hold your head nice and still now. Look right here. Eye cams are fun, aren't they? Look at me. Okay. That's excellent. Thank you, Stacy. Well, we've done a lot, haven't we? We've checked how well you can see, haven't we? Have we? Yeah, and we've tested how well your eyes move, and we've looked at the front of your eyes. Stacy, this eye examination has found out that you don't see well, and that you need glasses to see better. Let's tell your mother about them. These probably don't fit perfectly, but I can show you the characteristics of glasses. They have to fit well around the nose and fit comfortably so she can run around and jump up and down and not have them fall off. Do you want to show your mommy? Yeah. You're really going to like the glasses when you get them because they not only look pretty, but you're going to see better. And things will really be clear instead of blurry like they are now.
My home is in a northern place. Snowflakes fall about my face. Father hunts with dogs and sled. Arctic foxes prowl and chase. Though the winter nights are long, I am safe where I belong. Warm and wrapped inside my dreaming.
happened to those guys? You know, the Canadian brass said that we could do a number together today, but we were supposed to meet here 1/2 hour ago, and they haven't shown up yet. I think they're coming now. Hi, guys. Hey, listen, you know, we were supposed to meet 1/2 hour ago. What happened to you? Well, that's not really a very good excuse, you know. The trumpets? Well, I hope what you're saying is true. Is that true, what he just said about you guys? Oh, well, now you're starting to make some sense. Hey, listen, could we do our number? Hey, hold it, guys! Hold it! Could we just have something nice and simple? Play a simple melody like my mother sang to me. One with good old-fashioned harmony. Play a simple melody. Musical demon, set your honey a-dream, and won't you play me some rag? Just change that classical nag to some sweet, beautiful drag. If you will play from a copy of a tune that is choppy, you'll get all my applause. And that is simply because I wanna listen to rag.
On it and swim in it. Fish swim in it. Water puts out fires. Grows flowers and green lawns. It turns powders into nice things to drink. Vegetables into soup. Water can be made into ice that makes things cold and taste good. Water cleans things.
Dum dum dee doo dum dum do do dum.
Water can say we are sad, and then we can be happy again.
Once upon a time, on a beautiful sunny day in a faraway kingdom, the king decided he would have a picnic. So he invited everybody to his castle.
Well, good afternoon. afternoon, my royal subjects.
Good afternoon, King.
I've invited you all here to my castle to give a terrific royal picnic.
Yay!
Now, each one of you will bring something to the picnic.
Okay.
We'll have hamburgers and pickles and potato salad and soda and watermelon.
Okay.
So, everyone go and get some, then bring it to the picnic.
Okay!
Yeah!
So all the citizens hurried home to get things for the picnic. But when they returned, they discovered that a strange thing had happened.
Hey, look, Your Majesty, I brought something for the royal picnic. Watermelon.
Yeah, I brought watermelon, too.
Me, too.
Yeah, so did I. I brought some watermelon.
Now, hold on. Everybody brought watermelon to my royal picnic? Didn't anybody bring hamburgers or potato salad or something? You can't have a royal picnic with just watermelon. And I'm especially fond of potato salad.
Potato salad?
We can't have a royal picnic without potato salad.
Okay.
So everybody hurried home again. And this time, when they returned to the castle...
Hold on! You mean all of you brought potato salad? We can't have a picnic with just potato salad. Oh, what am I gonna do?
Pardon me, Your Majesty.
Yes, Prime Minister, what do you want?
Well, might I suggest, sire, that you plan your picnic.
Plan my picnic?
Plan his picnic?
Yeah. Just think of all the things that you'd like to have for your picnic, and then ask each person to bring a different thing.
Of course, that's what I'll do. I'll plan my picnic.
Good.
You bring the hot dogs.
You got it, King.
You bring the watermelon.
Sure thing, King.
And you bring the pickle relish.
You bet, King.
You bring the napkins.
It's a good plan, King.
You bring the mayonnaise.
Good plan, King.
You bring the mustard.
Good plan, King.
You bring the hard rolls.
Good plan, King.
You bring the soft rolls.
Good plan, King. And the King's plan worked. Everybody in the kingdom brought something different to the picnic, and everybody had a wonderful time.
You got the whipped cream.
We got it, King.
You got the sour cream.
We got it, King.
Well, I got the ice cream.
We got it, King.
Well, that's it.
Yum, yum. Yeah.
Ready? Did'em. Ready? Did'em. Ready? Did'em. Ready? Did'em. Come on over for chorus rehearsal, Charlie.
Sure thing, Fred.
Wait for me, guys.
Spunky little fellow.
I'll make it now, guys.
Hold the rehearsal. I'm coming, too.
I gotta get across, but I can't jump that far. What can I do? Not that way. That's it.
If you hang around playing with pebbles, Sonny, you'll never make it to the chorus.
I'll be there. Here I come.
Hello there, little frog. Glad you could make it. Say, the little guy's got a great tenor voice. Light.
Which is bigger, a tortoise or a turtle?
Tortoise.
Can cats see in the dark?
Yes.
Do owls sleep more in day or the night?
Your grandmother's here.
Hello, Linda. How are you?
Fine. How are you?
Fine.
Hi, Jennifer. Hi, sweetheart.
Wendy.
Yeah.
I'll keep the board set up and baby. You could come over Monday or Tuesday and we can finish the game.
Okay, that's great.
And thank you for coming, Wendy.
Okay,
it's
thanks
so
for
nice
lunch.
Having you.
Okay, see you on Monday.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Do you have enough vanilla?
Uh-huh.
My name is Wendy, and I live with my grandmother in New York. My great-grandmother lives in a nursing home around the corner.
Okay. Uh-huh. Do you have enough brown sugar?
Yes.
How about chocolate chips?
Uh-oh.
Would you like a bag for that?
No, thanks. Bye.
Thank you.
One cup of butter, softened.
Oh, we have to cut this up. Here we go.
3, 4, 5. One cup of all-purpose flour. 2 eggs.
Okay.
Half of a teaspoon of salt. Stir in chocolate chips. Grandma, do you like chocolate chip cookies?
Yes, I do.
Do you think Nanny will like them?
Oh, I think she would love them.
Great. Delicious.
That's it.
Finally done.
Now let them bake. Okay.
Are all the chocolate chips going to melt in the oven?
They should.
Push it back a little. Very good. Okay. That's really stuck. You want help? Oh. Okay.
Beautiful. Do you like them?
Have a taste of one.
Offering
some to the other girl.
To the other one,
To the other women.
Would you care to have them?
Yes.
Delicious.
Well, Wendy,
we will.
Wendy, yeah. Take it over, okay?
They're delicious.
They're homemade?
Yeah. Really?
Thank you. She made them. You made them yourself?
Isn't that great?
You made them,
Wendy?
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you very much. That's lovely.
Thank you, dear. Thank you very much.
That's
They're
nice.
Delicious.
Nice. You want one?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Wendy?
Yeah?
They're absolutely delicious.
Thank you. You can't put that on top of the two. You have to take it off. I won.
Yeah, she beat me. Okay, bedtime.
Okay.
Good night. Good night.
Good night, Grandma. I love you.
I love you, sweetheart.
Good night.
I come.
Ha ha! Miles! Oh, yes, I hope you're all ready for your big day.
Big day? What big day?
Today, Gordon. Because today is the day I teach Miles to count to 40.
Oh, really? How do you expect to do that?
By demonstrating how it is done. Here we go, Miles. Counting 1 to 40. 1.
Count.
2. 3. 4. 5. 6.
Count.
7. 8. 9.
There's no
10,
way you're.
11.
Wait a minute.
12,
count.
13. 14.
1 to
15,
40? Come
16.
On.
17. 18. 19. 20. 21,
wait
22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27,
no.
28, 29, 30,
would you wait
32,
a minute,
33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40. Wonderful.
Yeah. Now what?
Now, Miles, it is your turn to count.
Come on, count. I mean, you know perfectly well that Miles is just starting to learn to count. I mean, there's no way he's going to count to 40, even if you were to stand there and count all day.
Exactly. Sesame. Yes, I will show you again how to count from 1 to 40 miles. Here we go. A 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, a 6, a 7, 8, a 9, a 10, 11, 12, 13.
It's time for the hippest, newest, best-dressed detective show on television, Miami Mice.
Yeah, there are palm trees out there. What? What's on the palm tree? What's on? Oh, I'm on. Oh, I'm on. Oh, cue the music. Hi-ho, this is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the sunny tropics of Miami, Florida. Here to explore the idea of adventure. And who knows more about the subject of adventure than the world-famous Miami Mice? And here they are right now. Here is the Miami Mice, JP.
Oh, what's happening?
And Tito.
Tito, man.
Hey, guys, we would like to talk to you a little bit about the topic of adventure.
Say what, Frog?
You know, adventure, when something exciting happens to someone.
Adventure? Man, we got none of that here. Yeah, wish we could help you out, Frog.
Yeah, but you're the world-famous Miami Mice.
Hey, duck.
What? Ah! What was that?
That's some low-flying joker. Hey, you were shooting some questions, Froggo?
About adventures. Would you tell me some of the adventures you guys have had?
Nothing too interesting. We come to work, We do our job, we go home.
Yeah? You mean nothing happens? Wait a minute. What's that sound?
Hey, better hide, Froggo. Yeah.
What? Ah! Ah! Get along, little baby, get along!
Yeah, so go on, Frog. You were saying?
I was saying, what do you mean you don't have any adventures here? Look at all the exciting things that are going on here.
Like what, man?
Oh, well, I mean, the airplane comes through and there's the stampeding animals and...
Down quick.
What? Yeah. What's that? Ah! That's what I'm talking about. I mean, you got monsters stomping through here. How can you say that nothing exciting ever happens here? Look at all the exciting things that are happening here.
Just in a day's work, Frog.
A day's work, Frog Girl. Nothing much else today.
Yeah. I don't get it.
JP, hey, there it is, man.
Yes, indeed.
An adventure. Something exciting is about to happen, yes?
No, Frog Girl. What? It's quitting time.
Ah. Yes, indeed. Let's bolt.
This is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from Miami. I'm gonna go check out the local swamp.
1, 2, 3, 4! more fish.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Four line of toys.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Four arms.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Four
root beer floats.
There's a sign. Ha-at d-og. Ha-at d-og. What kind of sign is that? That's not one of those crazy signs. Ha-at d-og. Ha-at. Hot. Hot. Dog. Hot dog. Hot dog!
Man, you said it. I am one hot dog.
Hot dog.
Hi there. You know what this is? This is called a scale, and it's used to tell whether things are heavier or lighter than something else, you see? And I've got a pile of cookies on this side of the scale, and I have a pile of cookies on this side of the scale. But this pile of cookies over here is heavier because it has pulled the scale down low like this. If this side here were heavier, it would go down like that, you see? But this side here is lower. Now, what I wanted to do is I wanted to share these cookies with Bert, but I'm not sure exactly how to do it so that they're even.
You, excuse me, Ernie.
Oh, hi there, Cookie.
I was listening. You know how to do that? You don't know how?
No, not really. No? I was trying
okay,
to think
I know
it.
How. I help.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I help.
Oh,
okay.
Well, thank you.
Okay, good.
I guess.
Let me see now. This side here is dough. That means there are more cookies on than that side. So this is heavier, right?
That's heavier over there, yes.
Okay. Okay, now what you do is you take more cookies off this side, okay? Like this.
Oh, sure, that makes sense. Oh, yeah. Now, that side there is lighter, right? And this side here is heavier because now there are more cookies down here. Now, this side over here is the heavy side of the scale.
Oh, right. Me fix that.
Oh, yeah? No. That didn't work, Cookie. Look here. See, now this side of the scale over here is the heavy side. You see? Oh, it still doesn't balance,
course,
Cookie.
But I really fixed this time. Watch.
Hey, look at that. Look at that. It balances. It balances. Well, wait a minute.
What?
There are no cookies left.
Oh.
Well, you ate all the cookies.
I know.
I have this really good scale here and nothing to weigh on it.
Oh. Wait, really good scale?
Yes, it's a really good scale.
Let's see. Scale not so good. I taste it better. Bye-bye.
One day I was looking out my window, waiting for my brother to come home, and I had a funny idea. What's inside the street? I must have said it out loud, because a bird laying on the windowsill and said,
"Well, I used to wonder about that same thing, you know? I found out that a street is, it's like a cake."
A chocolate cake?
A cake of many colors, made up in layers. If you could peel off the layers, this is what you can find. Come on, these are the tracks that the old trolley cars rode on.
That was before I was born.
Oh, sorry. The cobblestones from horse and buggy days.
I can hear the horses.
Clippity clop clop clop. Oh, this is the dirt that was here before everything else.
I know all about dirt.
I see that. Sorry, the pipes that bring water and gas to your house.
And take the rain away?
Right. And the very bottom layer of this street is a subway.
Look, there's my brother coming home from work.
What? We better cover things up.
By the way, how did you find out what's inside the street?
What do you mean?
You fly around the air.
Right.
You're a bird.
Oh, a little worm told me.
Hey, Erica. Huh? Jessica, yeah. I got a great idea. Since you're here playing with me, why don't we go through my old toy trunk and we'll see what's in there. I haven't looked in there for a long time. Show me what's in there. See what's... Oh, look at this. You know what this is? This is my first truck. I used to play in the sand with this. What else is in there?
No, master.
Show me what else. What's this? Oh, look at that. It's my little toy tugboat. You know what I used to do with this? I used to play with Ernie in his bathtub, and he'd have his rubber ducky, and I have my little boat. Boop, boop, boop. What else is in there? Oh, no. You know what this is? Oh, look at that. See, it's got letters on it. You know what it is?
It's the ABCs.
The ABCs. You know what you call that?
Alphabet.
The alphabet. You know, the first time I saw that, though, I didn't know it was the alphabet. I thought it was a word. Oh, I was so embarrassed. I remember it clearly. Abkadefki Jekyll-Monopkorsturix is the most remarkable word I've ever seen. Abkadefki Jekyll-Monopkorsturix is. I wish I knew exactly what I mean. It starts out like an A word, as anyone can see. But somewhere in the middle, it gets awful queer to me. Abkadefki Jekyll-Monopkorsturix is. If I ever find out just what this word can mean, I'll be the smartest bird the world has ever seen. It might be kind of an elephant, or a funny kind of kazoo, or a strange exotic turtle that you never see in a zoo. It might be a kind of a doggy, or a particular shade of blue, or maybe a pretty flower. Nah, not with a name like that. Abkadefki Jekyll-Monopkorsturix is. It's the most remarkable word I've ever seen. Abkadefki Jekyll-Monopkorsturix is. I wish I knew exactly what I mean. It starts out like an A word, as anyone can see. But somewhere in the middle, it gets awfully queer to me. Abkadefki Jekyll-Monopkorsturix is. If I ever find out just what this word can mean, I'll be the smartest bird the world has ever seen.
Yes. S.
Dear Aunt Polly, thank you for the... Oh, no! The point of my pencil broke! Oh, now I can't finish writing my letter! Well, I'll just have to go and get my pencil sharpener. What good is a pencil without a point? You can't do anything with it.
What?
Oh! I know they won't get that.
They will. Yeah.
You don't have that, buddy, bitch.
It's a boy. Yeah, I got my door. Here, what? The window. There we go. Out the door. Yeah. There we go. Abby, come on back down.
Whoa! Wow! Amazing!
Demo Nana! Oh, no, Mana! Abby, come on back
down. Now, did you do that?
Demo Nana!
Oh,
Van Karian.
Pardon me. Excuse me. Excuse me, please. Excuse me. Okay.
Oh, thank you.
No.
Okay. Let's see. Okay. Now, let's see. Where was I? Dear Aunt Polly, thank you. Oh, yes. Okay. Thank you.
Oh, did you for...
Oh, well. Let me see. Thank you for the pencil. Oh, okay. Sharpener. Oh, no.
One. Two. Three. Four. Four dolphins. Four.
Okay, I've put up all the arrows. Oh, is Bert going to be surprised? Oh, Bert! Bert!
What, Ernie?
Come here, Bert.
Oh, Ernie, I'm reading. What do you want?
Take a look, Bert.
What?
See?
Ernie?
Hmm?
You've put arrows all over the walls of the apartment.
That's right, Bert.
But why did you do that?
For the game, Bert.
What game?
The game of Follow the Arrow.
Follow the Arrow?
You've heard of the game.
No, I have not heard of the game.
You haven't? Oh, it's a wonderful game, Bert.
Well, I don't care. Just take those arrows off the walls.
Well, I'll take them down after you play the game.
I don't want to play the game.
Good. Let me tell you how.
I don't
now,
want
right
to know
over
how.
Over here, this is the first arrow. Now, you follow that arrow and on to the next arrow and all the way around until you get to the last arrow, Bert.
Then what happens?
Then you get a surprise.
What kind of surprise?
Well, you get to see somebody that you like.
A pigeon?
I can't tell you, Bert. If I told you, that wouldn't be a surprise,
a
would
pigeon.
It, Bert?
A pigeon? I bet it's a pigeon.
Oh, I'm not saying, Bert.
Well, okay,
someone
I'll,
you like, though, Bert.
Somebody I like. I follow all the arrows, and I get somebody I like. Okay,
that's right. Start right there, Bert.
Okay, but after we do this, can we take all the arrows down?
Oh, sure, Bert.
Okay. And it could be a pigeon, you said. I heard you. Could be a pigeon. Okay, could be a pigeon. Okay, this arrow goes over here.
Mm-hmm.
This arrow goes down that way.
That's right.
This arrow goes over here. Mm-hmm. Ernie, you're not playing a trick on me, are you?
Bert, would I play a trick on you?
I'm not in the mood for tricks, Ernie. Okay. That arrow over there goes over here.
That's right.
And that arrow goes up here. You know what? And this arrow goes here.
Mm-hmm.
This is kind of kicky, Ernie.
Sure, Bert.
Yeah, it's better than washing socks.
It's a lot of fun, Bert.
Okay, this arrow goes here, and that arrow goes up there. And this arrow here goes down a little bit. And this arrow goes over here. Oh, boy, I'm getting warm. I know I am. And this arrow goes over here.
And that, Bert, that's the last arrow.
Goes over. Wait a minute. This arrow goes here. You're right, Ernie. It's somebody I like.
I told you it was, Bert.
Hi. You've been watching me play Game of Arrows, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, this is fun, Ernie.
Sure.
Any pigeons in there?
Okay, Bert, now I'll take down the arrows.
No, I'll play a game again, okay? Here we go. This arrow goes over here. This arrow over here.
Okay, kids, what's this?
It's a square.
Very good, Mary. It's a square. Come on, Lee, now straighten up. Attaboy. Okay, look sharp. What's this?
Triangle.
Very good, Leona. It is a triangle. Now, what's this one?
Circle.
Last one, Holmes, a rotten egg.
I'll play Holmes.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters S, N-T. And by the number 4. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.